for our top story this hour, we want to give you an update on a story in question has been following for quite some time now, Amazon's search for a second headquarters. Earlier this year, the tech giant released a list of 20 cities it was considering as potential locations for the offices. And today, we're learning two cities have been selected to split the project: Northern Virginia's Crystal City and Long Island City in New York. The news follows desperate attempts from state and local leaders to woo Amazon, with New York Governor Andrew Cuomo even joking he'd rename Newtown Creek in Long Island City to Amazon Creek to honor the company. But he didn't stop there, even suggesting he would change his own name to Amazon Cuomo, quote, if that's what it takes. But that's not the most bizarre ploy put forward to charm Bezos and Co. In Ottawa, hockey fans were forced to applaud for Amazon during halftime at a Senators game. And Tucson, Arizona even shipped Amazon's Seattle headquarters a 21-foot saguaro cactus in a failed bid to entice the company. Amazon says it did not accept the gift. Kansas City Mayor Sly James made courting the corporation his personal project, launching a campaign to write 1,000 five-star Amazon reviews.
Oh, boy. Pretty cool. Council, I am your mayor.
Much to the disappointment of Mayor James, a final decision has been handed down as residents in New York and Northern Virginia prepare to host Amazon's second headquarters. Some are raising concerns the endeavor may not be as profitable for local communities as many hoped.
Our main concern is that not only will Amazon coming to New York City not benefit longtime residents of New York City, but that they will actually displace a lot of residents of New York City through gentrification, rising rents, displacement of jobs. I mean, I think New York City is at a point where we don't need to recruit businesses to come here. There's lots of businesses that are coming here without any subsidies, without any tax breaks, without anything. And there's no reason that we should be offering up, I think it was rumored, $1 billion in subsidy dollars for them to come here. And on top of that, they're also asking for a lot of other public benefits, including, you know, a rezoning of land in Long Island City where they may be going.
With Amazon's HQ2 in question, I spoke earlier today with Kevin Gustafson, host of the podcast Sensible Socialist and organizer with Democracy at Work, D.C. Kevin, Amazon CEO Jeff Bezos recently purchased the largest home in all of Washington, D.C. for $23 million. So I guess it's not a surprise that he wanted to bring his corporation a little bit closer to the nation's capital. How did New York and Crystal City incentivize Amazon to make this decision?
Well, essentially, I would frankly call it corruption. The Transparency International defines corruption as the abuse of entrusted power for private gain, which is actually what I think happened in this case. You have Amazon, which is the largest retailer in the world, with profits just this last quarter of over $2 billion, employs 500,000 people. It's a major, major powerhouse in the United States, both economically and even politically. Its owner, Jeff Bezos, like you said, lives in D.C. He also owns the Washington Post. And actually, I think, if I remember correctly, his house is actually down the street from Barack Obama's house.
Yes.
So he's...
And Jared and Ivanka.
There you, exactly. So he's part of... He's already sort of put himself into the whole milieu of D.C. politics. And it's no surprise, especially the choice of something like Northern Virginia. It's obvious that Amazon wants to be closer to the federal government because it's looking at potential issues that have arisen out of the federal government, like Bernie Sanders making a campaign that resulted in the increase in wages at Amazon, though with the caveat that there were some cuts as well to pay for some of those, so it wasn't quite what we thought.
Right.
But that there is every reason to believe that as there are talks of potential antitrust issues and things like that, that it's very helpful for Amazon to want to be closer to the federal government.
We should clarify for viewers who may not realize, Northern Virginia, Crystal City is essentially a part of Washington, D.C. It's part of the greater DMV area. And in the case of New York, you know, people are talking about Governor Cuomo offering billions of dollars in subsidies. What's that about?
Exactly. So essentially the way that the corruption happened was that Amazon made the announcement that they were thinking about a second headquarters. Many of us thought that that was because they wanted to get out of Seattle or move away from Seattle, given the fights that are happening in Seattle regarding a head tax that Amazon pushed vociferously against. But the way that company or that cities were incentivizing Amazon was through massive investments, either in Amazon through tax relief or literally investments in the areas around where they potentially would be.
From the government.
From the actual government. So in New York, the total is somewhere around $1.5 billion.
Wow.
And this is at a time, and the thing is going to be in Queens, and Queens has had major issues with particularly housing, and the subway is actually deteriorating, and the city of New York and the state of New York has said, we just don't have the money to deal with these problems, yet they're able to give $1 billion to Amazon.
This is literally money that could be used to invest in things people already living there need, and yet they're promising it to a corporation.
The most profitable corporation in the world.
Stunning. Amazon is promising to boost local economies, pledging to bring some 25,000 jobs to each city. Based on Seattle's experience, though, where Amazon's first headquarters is located, what impact can we expect the company's presence to have in New York and Virginia?
So the estimates as to how many jobs that Amazon will actually be able to bring in is in the incentive documents that were released, which are very interesting reads. But there is no necessarily assurance that these jobs will actually be created. The jobs that will be created, they are touting as being jobs that are paying over $100,000 a year, meaning that a significant amount of the workforce is already just not even in competition for these jobs. They are particular jobs of privileged, more wealthy people already who have had the opportunity to get jobs that would pay them $100,000. But in Seattle, what you have is you have had Amazon, this major headquarters, and what you have is consistent and persistent housing issues. There's been massive development like we've seen in D.C. and other places that are just pricing people out. There's a major homelessness campaign. And in Seattle, what you have is the nation's only elected socialist who is in the city council who proposed a fairly mild head tax, just a couple $100 per employee for any company over $20 million in revenue. And Amazon knew that it was the target of that, and that would be paying for helping this homelessness problem. And they came down and really destroyed it.
Well, very briefly then, what did you make of all of those leaders, for example, the mayor of Kansas City begging Amazon to essentially come in and do business despite these issues which you've outlined?
Well, the funny thing about something like Kansas City particularly is that Kansas City has been in some ways the epicenter of this whole project that cities have been engaged in, giving tax advantages and trying to lure different businesses in. Kansas City is on the border between two states, and so the state governments have created all kinds of different incentive programs to lure businesses to come across the border. And what happens a lot of times is that the business will move, get the advantage, and then maybe move back to get a new advantage. And so the fact that, you know, Kansas City is doing this means that it really hasn't learned its lesson. And it does show the fact that the politicians in all of these areas, in New York, in the Virginia area, Kansas City, and many of the 250 other places that were vying for it, they care more about the possibility for these kinds of jobs to come in and the possibility for the investment that Amazon will bring. And they're using Amazon's figures to decide whether or not this is actually going to happen. The fact of the matter is that many times these businesses come in, take advantage of the advantages that they can, and engage in further activities to engage in further tax advantages like moving overseas or other kinds of things. These tax incentives tend to be a drain on resources of cities, and they don't produce the kind of benefits that the company claims that will happen.
Well, it's all very interesting, especially because I feel like no one's questioning this in the mainstream media. So we're not going to stop following the story, especially as they start building the headquarters just a little bit away from us. And we'll bring you back to talk about it then. Kevin Gustafson, thanks so much.
Thank you.
Hey, YouTube, thanks for checking out our channel. We hope you enjoyed the video. We have tons of content for you just like this. For more of RT America's one-of-a-kind news and analysis, be sure to subscribe and never stop questioning more.